person who has a sadhu practicing all yoga and everything at the age of 55, after 32 years of sannyas, he got married. So what's this? It's very clear that things are being forced. Your own karma, your own past actions will force you for reproduction also. And 90% of the world public, the world population, are under this prakriti, under this maya. They can't get out so easily, get into sadhana and spirituality at all.
Even wanting sadhana or spirituality is a desire.
Huh?
Even wanting sadhana or spirituality is a desire.
It's a better desire than the worldly desire. You see, always say, you know, you see, in the shastras, in the scriptures, very, it's told very clearly. First is the lokvasana. This is called as, the worldly wishes are called as lokvasana. You have to tackle this lokvasana and overcome this lokvasana by shastravasana. What? Shastravasana. Practicing the shastras, reading the shastras, swadhyaya pravachanabhyam apramaditavyam, taittira upanishad vesitas, very clearly about this. So through shastravasana, we are getting rid of the worldly vasana. And that shastravasana also should be get rid of. Otherwise you will not get liberation. You are attached to no shastra. Before you were attached to the world, now you are getting attached to shastra, attached to your sadhana. There should be no attachment even towards your sadhana. As we give an example, you are sitting in a boat and you cross the river. Will you not give up that boat? If you don't give up that boat, will you get into your home? You have to give that boat also to get enter into your home. Similarly, the sadhana is also a means to reach our goal. We have to give up these means also. If we are attached to our means, then we are not able to get into the liberation. So, it is a better desire. From the worldly desire, we have to get a spiritual desire. From spiritual desire, we have to get into sadhana, more practice, spiritual practices desire. For that, give up even that also and become the spirit. To be the spirit. Not to become actually, to be the spirit, what am I? To experience that. Because we do experience that I am existing. Is it not? Everybody is experiencing here that I am existing. Even the insects, even animals, everybody experience that I am existing. Existence is known by one and all, but we are not aware of our existence all the time. The problem is the awareness. Similarly, we know we are conscious when we are in the waking state. But that consciousness which we are experiencing in this waking state is there during the dream state also and even in the sleep state. But are we aware of it? No. Similarly, what all experience where enjoyment is going on, we are enjoying. But in that enjoyment is only related to the worldly objects. Behind this enjoyment, the sensual enjoyments and the basal and the basis is the actual bliss. That absolute bliss is within. We are experiencing a drop of it as sensual enjoyment. But we are not becoming or trying to become aware of our own that absolute bliss. Therefore, the spirituality means to become more and more and more aware of our own absolute existence, absolute consciousness and absolute bliss. Vaid Chetana in the sense is actually is the absolute and the pure. 100% you can say. That's called as Chetana. And Urja is at a very gross level and the subtle levels, which is that which is above gross and subtle, and the causal also, is called as Chetana. Because Chetana, the word is from Chetan. Chetan means Chaitanya. That is Atma, the spirit. That which is related to is called as Chaitanyam, which we are experiencing this body. So the body and mind mechanism is a means to experience that Chetana. And how to express that chetana through the body-mind mechanism? Is to channelize all the urja, the energies, both in the physical and subtle body, that we do have through asana, pranayama, mudra, works for expenses, ashtanga yoga. You have to channel all this urja, all this energy towards that particular point. So that's when Yoga Sutra is said, the Vyasa Bhasha says, the vritti, the energy flow, the urja that is going on in the body, has got two veins. Two way running it is. Most of the time it is running only towards the world. Rarely, especially during the sleep state, it is going towards the self. So now, put a dam over here. Let the energy, the urja, to flow towards the world. And at the same time, open a canal towards the other side. So, abhyasa vairagya abhyam tan nirodha. Yoga Sutra says, abhyasa vairagya abhyam tan nirodha. Vairagya means stopping the flow as a dam. And abhyasa is the canal.
Yes.
You see, it is a part of Tantra. It is not a wrong statement. It is a part of Tantra. If you read my yoga book also, I have written that among the different means of Samadhi, different practices also, Sambhoga is also one. I have mentioned in my book also that. But, yes, what is Sambhoga? You know yoga, you know, have heard the name Rishi Vasistha? Yeah, how many children he had got? It said 100 children. Okay? But at the same time, the same scriptures say, he is akhanda brahmachari. Actually, what is the meaning of brahmacharya for women? And for man, that is to be understood properly. Every grihastha can become akhanda brahmachari. But you follow the scriptural orders. It says, Ritau Bharyam Abhigachet. Ritau Bharyam Abhigachet. After the monthly MC cycle that takes place in every woman, of the last that you see, visualize that, that day is, that night is called the first night. You have 3 days, 4 days, 5 days also MC takes place for different women. So whatever it is, after that, the end of that is the first night. Live 2 nights, he says. The third night from that day, every husband has got the right to sleep with the wife. And that Sambhoga is Brahmachari. And if that too done according to yogic way, just like the human or the animal way, not that, you should be aware of your own self, the whole body and the husband's body. There should be not excitement, not sensual enjoyment, but it should be totally for spirituality. We read the process of that Sambhoga. It is not just what the people do. The yogic Sambhoga to Samadhi is totally different. You can read the book, you will understand what it is. How many hours before the preparation starts for that? It is said a minimum of 3 hours. A minimum of 3 hours. Without any excitement. The relationship is there. No movement is there. Even after relation, no movement. Remember these words. If it is possible with you, then you are there for that. But is it possible each and every woman and every person? No. That is why, and the present Kali Yuga, at the present stage of this age, is very, very difficult to practice Sambhoga to Samadhi. Because if you want to attain that before marrying, the person should have practiced very well Vajroli. Vajroli is a Kriya. And the woman has to practice Sajroli, even that is another Kriya. Both should learn that properly. Be tamed with that. Then if you have going to Sambhoga to Samadhi, surely you will attain Samadhi. But I don't think there's any such couple in this world in the present day who have got that ability with Vajroli and Sajroli.
About responsibility, now the way human beings are made, as soon as child is born, then uska pitrin hota hai, matrin hota hai, and then he has to have responsibilities for his home. And then those responsibilities, now suppose even if the child is 12 or 13 or 14 years old, may decide to follow the spiritual path or become a sannyasi or what. What about his duties and responsibilities? And if he doesn't fulfill, then bodhin aayega.
No. You see. Anything is considered as a responsibility. Only if you accept it as a responsibility, is it not?
No, it is written.
It's not like that. No, scripture says yahi likha hai. Kya likha wo samjho. For whom it is? There are two different types of people in the whole world. One who are in the trap of avidya. The other who are ready to seek vidya. The person who wants to seek vidya has no rina. It is not just by birth that rina comes on you. In Aitriya Upanishad, you might have heard an Upanishad is there. Read the Shankara Bhashya in the very Bhumika, in the beginning. The introductory Bhashya itself, very, very clear in this matter. That one who accepts that I am the son of so and so, then all responses come to him. But a person who gets spirituality, as I have told before, very first thing is that I am not the son of anybody. I am not at all limited to family. I am not limited to one and something. But I am one who thinks for the whole world, for good of the world, good of the whole universe. I am a part and parcel of the universe, but not of a family. Where the rana comes then? It's only when the person is accepting himself like a Kupa Manduga. You understand Kupa Manduga? A person is limiting himself within certain limitations. On such people only, the Pitrana, Devrana, Rishalana comes on him. A person who breaks up this limitation, tries to become one with, or test experience, or go towards that experience also. Even if Vidishu sannyas, there are two types of sannyasis also. One is Vidvat sannyasa, and one person who has Vidishu sannyas. There are two divisions in that. A person who is attained and gets into sannyas, a person not yet attained that state, but he wants to attain. For that is getting into the spiritual path. Even he also has no responsibility of anything in this world. The only responsibility is of himself becoming he who he is. The only responsibility of a sannyasi is to experience what am I. There is no other responsibility. And if a person thinks that I am bound to the society, that means he is accepting the society, he is the biggest foolish sannyasi. Our Guruji, Paramaswami Satyan Saraswati of Bihar School of Yoga, was stating very clearly, don't follow the literate fools. He would say to such people as literate fools who are thinking that I am bound to the society, I have got certain duties and responsibilities to the society, is not at all a sannyasi.
Swami, you
क्रिया योग भी है, अष्टांग तो एक साधना है केवल सामान्य। नहीं, देखिए, I'll explain that now for the word yoga. We have discussed a lot of spirituality. I think that's enough of spirituality. And I think the word of yoga and the means of yoga. Yoga is made by two verbal roots. Yujir yoge and yujir samadhi. Yoga means to join, union. And samadhi means to become one. The oneness. Samyak adhyate ekasmin iti samadhi. All that we are seeing, the multitude, the duality. To let this whole energy, the mind forces and everything to experience the non-duality form of yourself is called a samadhi. And yoga in the beginning he says is for samadhi. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. And after that, whenever he speaks of yoga, it is for the union. How to unify this individual Atman, the self, the empirical self, with the cosmic. That union, the means, different means of union are called as yoga also. And the goal is also called as yoga. In both these sense, the word yoga has been used there. So, usually yoga, yoga means to join, to unify. That is the different means we are using to completely bring an end to the notions of individuality. The means that we are adopting to bring an end, or in the word, in the philosophical word, is to culminate the individual identity into the supreme identity. That is, the means are called as also yoga. And that supreme identity which we are going to attain, that entity is also called as yoga. Yoga Brahman is a person who has come into this path but could not attain the final goal before that his body demises. You see, there's no question means of these things. That's your prarabdha. Because you have to practice. God has said very clearly, Gita, Aneka Janma Sansiddha. It does not take place of one single birth. It takes in many births. The sadhaka, a spiritual aspirant, having treading on this path, always I say that is why, if try and try again, at last you will succeed. I remember one doha of Kabir about a spiritual aspirant. He says very nicely, Chinti chade pahad par nau man tel lagai. Chinti chade pahad par nau man tel lagai. Hati chadai peet par oont bagal latkai. Hati chadai peet par oont bagal latkai. This is what the state of each and every sadhak. We are just like an ant, chinti. And we are thinking of climbing the Kailas Parvat, what you are seeing just before. Chinti chade pahad par, to attain that Shiva, the Supreme. And how? With all these 9 doors open. Now, man tel lagai means what? Oil is makes you slippery. We are slipping out through these doors. Now man, now chidra, navadware pure dehi. Through these chidra, through these senses, the mind is going out. Now man, now means now dwar actually. Man means mind is slipping again and again towards the world. Thinking of spirituality, but running towards the world, that's the foolishness that's happening with one and all. Secondly, he says, what else is with that? With you, a sadhak. Hati chadai peet par. A lot of sins and virtues, a bundle of karma we are having on us, which we are wishing to enjoy. Until and unless we are not going to give up this, how can we attain the goal? And apart from that, he says, unt bagal latkai. That is, always we are egoistic. We have our own ego. We don't want to give up our ego. How you are going to attain the Supreme? So Hati, that is the elephant here, is denoting all your karma. And the wound, the camel, is denoting the ego. A person who gives up these things, that the ant, if it has to reach the top of the hill, what it has to do? It has to give up the elephant, give up everything, then it can go over there and concentrate. Simply we have to give up our karma. We have to give our ego. We have to give up this sensual enjoyment. Then this has to be enjoyed for spirituality. I am not saying that you should not see the thing. See, but see what is there behind that. There is a cinema song also actually, in whatever sense you might have sung, but it is very good for a sadhak. पर्दा है पर्दा पर्दे के पीछे पर्दा नहीं है It is a cinema song, I don't know in which context it has been sung, but I take it as a bhajan for a sadhana. You see the parda, what is the picture in the parda, but try to understand and point out your mind, concentrate your mind towards that which is behind the parda. This whole world is a beautiful screen. Every of us, everyone here enacting our own part in a different way. But try to be a seer apart from this acting. Let the body mind act. I am acting, I am sitting here, I am speaking at present, you are listening, I am seeing this whole scenery. Keeping away one side. Similarly, if you are seeing everything, enjoying whatever you want to enjoy, enjoy it. But try to go to the root of that enjoyment, due to which you are able to get enjoyment from it. You are enjoying the scenery. Behind that enjoyment, this scenery is totally, completely jada. There cannot be enjoyment in it. Because some see, they feel very sorrowful. Some others enjoy. That is, either sorrow or enjoyment is not in that particular scene. There's something else behind it, which is making us experience it. Concentrate on that point. Then you'll enjoy it. देखिए वेदांत भी वेद का हिस्सा है. वेदांत इज नॉट अ डिफरेंट थिंग फ्रॉम वेदा. वेदांत इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ वेदा. वेदांत इज अ पार्ट ऑफ वेदा. देखो व्हाट वेदांत इज सेइंग एंड व्हाट वेदा इज डिड टू डू, इट कैन नॉट बी टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स. बट वी डू बाइफर्केट इट टू डिफरेंट डिविजन्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द पर्पज ऑफ दैट. वी हैव टेकन ऑल दैट पोर्शन विच इज रिलेटेड टू अविद्या एंड अविद्यावान पुरुष एज वेदा. And all that is related to a mumukshu, sadhaka, spiritual aspirant as Vedanta, for our own purpose. Actually, though Veda, even because the Upanishad is a part of Veda, the goal of Veda is what? To experience you the Advaita. But how are you going to experience the Advaita? Without Advaita? It is impossible. You have to begin from the Veda and end at Advaita. Nahi karmanamanarambhat naishkarmyam samashtute. In Gita, it is told very clearly, without starting any perfect action, you cannot end into inaction. Nahi karmanam anarambhat naishkarmyam. Your own self is what? Its form is non-dual, means it is inaction. To enter into that state, you have to start from action, from devotion, from thought. That is why, as I said in the very beginning, any Veda, any Smriti you see, is given karma, upasana and jnana. Action, devotion and knowledge. Unless until you will not be able to blend these three properly, channelize all these three energies within your body, the physical, the emotional and the mental energies, channelize them properly, diffuse them in a proper way and blend it in such a way that you are what you are. You should be able to experience what I. That depends upon each and every spiritual aspirant. It will be different sadhana. That's why I said, as per Shankaracharya, to attain such a guru is also the most important thing. Who can understand in what stage am I? And who can lead me to the right path to attain liberation? So Mahapurusha Sanshraya is the most important. But we are running behind the advertisements. If we run behind advertisements, we can never attain that. The ads is good for a beginner, for a person who does not do anything, but not for a spiritual aspirant. A spiritual aspirant has to pray. That's what Ishwar Pranidhana. You have to pray to God daily to attain a proper guru. Which is the most difficult? कई है उपनिषदों में है. योग कुंडली उपनिषद है, योग शिखामणि उपनिषद है, योग संबंधी अनेक उपनिषद है. यस 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 discussing different Kundalini Yoga, your Kundalini Upanishad is there. But that is piece of Kundalini. Kundalini is just a pada, that is just now what is spread is Urja, the Shakti. And that Shakti is, when it gets transformed, it becomes one with the Chetana, it's called as Kundalini. In simple words.
Okay. I have a question. You know, these sages and these seers who could look into the future, and they were the ones who were very concerned about as to what exactly is going to be the fate of humanity which follows subsequently. And they evolved Darshan, which is our Hindu philosophy, wherein they propounded the four endeavors and the four results thereof, which is dharma, arma,
kama, moksha. Yeah.
And this is what precisely they were probably thinking at that point in time, that for we people who are born in the Kali Yuga, that for our emancipation and for our salvation, we have to be sustained by this
four properly. Yeah.
By this chaturstha. That is dharma, artha, kama, moksha, in which desires are there, in which the need of material things is very much going to be a part of life. That is how this beautiful world which is there today, the auditorium in which we sit today, this has all become possible primarily because of the efforts of people and because of their material acquisitions and their efforts to be able to achieve this. But there is one underlining statement that all this should be sustained by dharma or righteousness.
Yes.
All this should be sustained
yes,
by dharma.
Yes, yes.
Therefore,
artha also for dharma only.
Everything.
Kama also for dharma only.
I agree with
you.
That's precisely what I'm trying to say. So, in this world today in which we are living, all of us, in whichever stage we are, in whichever ashram we are of life, if you look at the Hindu darshan, you're looking at sannyas, you're looking at brahmacharya, you're looking at Grahastha ashram. So in all these ashrams, each one of us can be in a very, very blissful state with all these things and all these efforts. So there is absolutely no problem. My being in the Grahastha ashram and trying to aspire what probably somebody in the sannyas ashram or a sannyasi is trying to aspire, probably there will be a conflict. If I am sustained by righteousness, let's say we were talking about celibacy and brahmacharya, which probably is very, very, you know, misunderstood by most of the people. We are in a wonderful relationship as a husband and wife, and we are sustained by righteousness in that relationship.
Mm-hmm.
We are sustained by that. That means, insofar as I am concerned, I am in a physical and an emotional and a totally mental relationship with my partner and my wife. So the institution of marriage has been given such a sanctity in our Hindu culture and religion. I would want you to slightly expound on this so that we could understand it in totality much better than what we perceive it.
Yes.
As
actually, the Grahastha, all the four ashramas, Brahmachari ashrama, Grahastha ashrama, Vanaprastha ashrama and Sannyasa ashrama, each and every ashrama is entitled to do all sadhana being in that enfoldment to attain the liberation. And as told by you, dharma artha kama moksha also can be practiced. Every brahmacharya ashram dharma is different. Grahastha ashrama dharma is encoded properly, it's different. Similarly, vanaprastha ashrama, every have got their own dharma. And that dharma which has been prescribed by the scripture has to be followed. Even artha and kama should be concentrated for that particular purpose to a certain stage. Because the rishis are not speaking only of the final stage and expecting each and every pandi to be eligible for that particular stage. They are concentrating on each and every stage person. For different stage people, they are explaining different sadhanas, different dharma, different kama, different artha, and all for moksha. So therefore, being a grihastha also, as I told before, when she asked about celibacy, I said, no, you can't think that you are not entitled that and through sambhoga also samadhi is possible. I said, yes. But condition is, as per scriptures, you have to follow them. The scriptures, the shastras have told, the yogas also told, how you have to go, monthly once, not many times. Being in grihastha, you are akhanda brahmachari. But instead of going for monthly once, you go many times, then you are not a brahmachari. That's animal hood again. That's why in the very beginning of Niti Shastra, what they said, four things are common in human being and animals also. Is it not? Ahara nidra bhayamaitunancha. Ahara nidra bhayamaitunancha. Samana metat pashvir naranam. Dharmohi eko adhiko visheshav dharmayana hina pashvisamana. So ahara, food, that's common. You are also taking, they are also taking. But if you are understanding what I am eating, the quantity what I have to eat, the sanctity, the purity and everything about that, sattvika, rasika, tamasika, that you can understand it properly. The animals can't do that. So that's the difference that you have to adopt if you want to become spiritual being in grihasthasana or any ashrama. Similarly, above that ahara, says nidra. How much time you have to sleep? If your sleep is not proper, being in grihastha, you cannot become a proper sadhaka. How much we have to sleep? He said very clearly, after 3 hours of the sunset, after 3 hours of the sunset and before 3 hours of sunrise, in between the 6 hours only, a person has to sleep. If you are taking more than that, then you are not a spiritual sadhaka. Being in whichever ashram, I don't mind, even I still speak for myself. If I am awake after 9 p.m. and if I am sleeping after 3 a.m., I am not a sadhu. I am not a sadhaka at all. Whether it is a grihastha or sannyasi, it does not matter. There is general formula, general rules. Ahara nidra. Third is bhaya. If you have got Ishwar Pranidhana, your question, then why question of bhaya? Why you are fearing of anybody or anything? When I was going to that jungle where I am living at present, people said, Swamiji, where are you going? There is no security, nothing. You should keep some security guard and this and that. I said, I have got 33 crore security persons. 33 crore devatas are mera security hai. Mujhe koi security ki zarurat nahi. You should have confidence in that God and the God's ministry which is there, which is ruling this world. That surrender, if total surrender is there and confidence is there in that, there is no question of bhaya at all. And if there is bhaya of any type in you, then you are not a spiritual aspirant at all. So ahara nidra bhaya. And the last is maithuna. That was sambhoga which he said. So that also, it has to be followed according to the rules and context that has been given for you, for grihastha ashrama. If you are following, then you are best spiritual aspirant. But is it possible for each and every couple, as I have put this question before? Ahara Shuddhi is very difficult in the present day. Is it not? Sattvic Ahara, Sattvic food, as in Gita and other places. What is Sattvic food? What is the Rajasa? It is very clearly mentioned in Gita. So that Sattvic food we have to maintain in whichever ashram we are, to become a spiritual aspect. The quantum of what we are sleeping should be fixed up. Not more than 6 hours in the night. And yogic sleep in the day. Not sleeping, but yogic sleep and sleep is two different things. After taking food, the lunch, lie down straight in Shavasana, but folding the legs up. Count down eight breath. Shvasa, coming in and out 8 times. Then take a right turn. Dayana karvatli jiye. 16 breath. Baya karvatli jiye. 32 breath. Having counted this, now get to total shavasana for 5 minutes. Get up, sit in vajrasana for 5 minutes. Get into your work. That is your sleep during the daytime. How many are following this? Who are thinking of themselves as yogis? So how we can accept any person as yogi and a yogi as spiritual aspirant? So you don't follow yogic sleep. You don't follow yogic diet. Is it not? Ahara nidra. and a lot of fear of everything and around you. So where you are then? Samanametat pashvir naranam. These are equal both in animals and human beings. That has started in the very beginning. The most important qualification to become eligible for spirituality is manushyattvam, the true humanity within yourself. Give up this animalhood that is within us and become true human beings to become spiritual. Hari Om Tat Sat.